I have been waiting for this day for quite some time. Gamers, gamettes, and everybody in between, it's your boy QYZ, and if you've been following this channel for any amount of time, you will know that Mortal Kombat is a big thing on this channel. We got MK11, we got MKX. I don't know if you guys followed me way back when, but we even have MK9. If you followed me way back on the Twitch days, you will see me playing 1, 2, 3, 4, Goal, Trilogy, Deadly Alliance, Deception, Armageddon. Yes, we played a lot of things, especially, I don't know if any of you guys remember, Mortal Kombat Kart and Mortal Kombat Chess and the Puzzle Fighter that was in Deception. If y'all don't remember those days, you missed out, because those were some of the greatest mini game modes to ever grace a fighting game, all time, no cap. That being said, I know that like a lot of us have been like longing for a full-fledged movie, because let's face it, the last time we got an MK movie, we had Annihilation. And the only thing that Annihilation did was make my stomach want to churn and annihilate the bathroom. That's it. It was the drizzling shits. It's just what it was. I got to be honest with you. Got to be forthright. It was just bad. The first Mortal Kombat movie to this day, remains the reigning, defending, undisputed champion of how to do a video game adaptation in the movies. It's still number one, as far as I'm concerned, in my humble opinion. But that being said, the second one was, as I said, terrible. And then we got a trailer, like, I'd say about 5, maybe 6 years ago now, where it had Michael Jai White, and then they decided to, like, merge Baraka and Reptile into one character, give him a lab coat, and give him dreadlocks. It was really weird. Really troubling times in the MK fandom. But we're here now. We're moving forward. I am ready, like SpongeBob SquarePants. Let's get to it. Been waiting a long time. Run it. Run it. Bring it. Bring it to me. First learned about this 7 years ago. Okay, the bunch of ice. Already know Sub-Zero's in here. Oh, wait. Hold on, Jax. Yo, give him that. Oh. Nah, Jax, give him the hands. You don't need no gun. Show him why you the man. No, you can't lose your arms already. Okay. All right. I think that kind of deconfirms Ermac, right? It's a birthmark. He was born. Hold on. She's like, it's a birthmark. He was born with it. There's some disembodied voice. It's not a birthmark, Cole. Like, how do we 180 that fast? Who made this trailer? All right, that's just funny to me. But who's Cole? That's my first question. I'm assuming that's supposed to be the NPC. We're supposed to project ourselves and being the outsider of the Mortal Kombat spectrum onto. All right, fine, whatever. Understandable, I guess, you know, if you want to catch a new audience. You're obviously going to have someone that the audience can imprint on. So, all right, relatable character number 5. Cool, whatever. Second thing, I'm worried. Because I don't know if you guys remember Mortal Kombat Annihilation. Yes, the movie with Too Bad You Will Die. Yeah, that scene. They had tattoos and birthmarks. And no, just trust me. No, please have no relation to that. Okay, it's an invitation. I don't know how you'd have an invitation for that at birth. That's weird. But all right, we are not shy from the gore in this film. And Hanzo's family just gets wiped out. All right. Wait, your champ? Wait, that's Kano. Wait. Sonya, Kano, and Jax on the same team? I don't buy it. Wait, no, he was right. Hold on, wait a minute. I have to go back. Wait a minute. There's no way. So I ended up getting a freeze frame here. And yes, he's rolling with them? There's no way that Kano doesn't betray them, right? Like, there's no way in hell that, like, he doesn't, like, between you and me, there's no way this does not end in him betraying them. Like, there is 0% chance. This is weird. This is jarring. I did not expect this. Okay. Any of my people you put in the ground. That was an interesting take on Melina. I don't hate it. I think that was Shang Tsung. Ooh, we actually summoned it. Oh, whoa. Well, that Goro was actually kind of sick. All right, the special effects, they're kind of hit or miss, but most of them is hitting. I can't really... Damn, Scorpion went down like a bitch. Hold up, wait a minute. Did you just throw him like some garbage? Okay, I'm not a fan of that. Get over here. I'm not even going to lie to you. All right, you know, it's kind of brutal. All right, kinda may have been maybe I undersold a little bit, but please tell me that wasn't Reptile that I just saw, because that wasn't attractive. That, look, I already went through this in Deadly Alliance when he had the crab fighting style and Reptile was running around going, meep, 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 meep. I already had enough of that. I don't need to see, can I just get human Reptile, the one with the hands, not the claws and the talons, the hands. Regular ninja attire would be most acceptable. Muy bueno if we could get that. Now, if that's just someone who's part of the Saurian race, which is the species that Reptile is part of, then okay, cool. Unnamed Saurian character in reptilian form. Great. Personally, cool with that. Whatever. GGs. Good job, Kano. You killed one. But I have so many questions. Like, Kano's a good guy? Like, there's... That's got to be a bill. Like, that is a bill of goods. I refuse to believe. He's betraying him. There's no way. I just can't accept that. He's betraying him. He's going to betray him, and he's going to piss on somebody's grave. It's the only way. It's the only way. It doesn't even look right that he's a good guy right now. But all in all, trailer looks okay. I'm not going to sit up here and, like, gas it up, but I'm not disappointed. I'm not hurt. From what I saw there, if Annihilation is here, it's up there in the skybox right now. This is looking like we are on the right path. We are going in the right direction. Now, we didn't really get to see Steve Harvey mustache in full effect when it came to Jax there, as we saw in some of the promo material. But I got to be honest with you. This movie looks like it's doing a lot. And my only fear is that it's doing too much. And what I mean by too much is some movies that are adaptations tend to try to fit three arcs into one film just because they want to throw as much fan service and characters at the audience. And it seems like this one's trying to be more grounded by having this Cole character and these other NPCs that we've never heard of before. So they could try to, like, make the movie more relatable and tell a full-fledged story. And if there's going to be a multitude of movies, like making a saga or something like that, or an extended cinematic universe, then all right, fine. I'm cool with that. But you can't just throw like 40 characters and then expect the audience at large that are not combat fans to care about them. And I just don't want this movie to do too much, because, I mean, Spider-Man 3 did that where it had too much going on. So all the villains couldn't really get their motivations clear and they didn't all have time and they kept... You guys know what I'm talking about. You don't want that. You don't want Sandman, Venom. You don't want them doing all of that all at once. It's just too much. It's just a congested plot. So we'll see. So far, I'm looking like it's okay. I'm on board. HBO Max, I will be there. I don't know. I mean, during COVID, I'm not seeing who's going to see who's going out here for IMAX. Like, I just don't see why during COVID I'm going to a movie theater. But hey. You do you. You always do. And remember, have a good set of games and an even better day. I'm stoked. I'm actually kind of happy. I'm excited. I'm ready. My body is ready, as one Reggie feels a me once said. And I'll see you guys next time. Cheers.